Hey guys, Mad Mike Wilson with Independent MMA and Fitness. Just want to do a quick video for the Josh the Man Foundation and let y'all know what MMA means to me. Started off training here, I guess about 3 years ago. Something I've always wanted to do. You know, always been in love with MMA, watched UFC, you know, did backyard fights, you know, at the house. But, you know, never thought it was something I could actually do. Well, I hit some rough times, rock bottom. You know, I finally was like, hey, I'm gonna do something for me. I'm gonna do something I've always wanted to do. And hit up one of my old guys I went to school with who trained, and he introduced me to the people down here at Independent. And man, it just changed everything. Started training with Professor Chris Ruiz and fell in love with Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu. Started helping him out with the kids' classes, you know, here and there. Lost my first two amateur fights, you know, had some trials coming in, but, you know, realized that, you know, if I stayed dedicated and kept working, you know, that I could accomplish everything, you know. So, you know, with that, I got to the point where I pretty much lived in the gym, you know, 6 days a week, you know, working as hard as I could. Eventually started a Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu minis program for kids ages 3 to 7 at the gym. You know, to kind of give back, help them as much as I could. And got my kids both, you know, training, you know, got them working towards, you know, bigger goals and bigger things. So really couldn't have found a better place or a better thing to be. Now in my 30s, I'm, you know, healthier than I ever was in my 20s, you know, feel better than I ever did, and in a better place in my life. So I can't put enough thanks to the sport of MMA for getting me where I'm at. Like I said, the one of the main things that is teaching. You know, I started off at the gym, you know, coming in 3-4 days a week and just helping with the kids' classes. And man, it's just, you know, seeing how it changes them, you know, from the kids who come in with their head down and, you know, not looking at you, to the kids, you know, that, you know, within a year or so, you know, are some of the biggest helpers that are always looking at, you know, the new kids coming in, helping them. It's just amazing to watch all of them grow. So, like I said, my goals in MMA, as far as, you know, a lot of people told me, you know, I didn't get started, you know, till I was, you know, in my late 20s, or like, oh, you might not make it here, you might not make it there, but hey, look, I'm all the way. You know, this is a lifestyle. It's not just something I wanted to do as a bucket list, or oh, I want to tell somebody that I'm a fighter. This is what I do. I'm in here every single day, you know, just working harder, getting better. You know, if I make it to the USC, hey, that's great. If I don't, you know, it doesn't bother me either. You know, I'm in here to test myself, you know, every day, become a better person, become a better martial artist. And if nothing else, I want to leave, you know, a legacy and be able to teach, you know, just other people, you know, bring them to the point where I'm at in life, to the part, you know, where I know how to deal with, you know, situations of anger, frustration, you know, overcoming those adversities that you learn on the mats, whether it's, you know, jiu-jitsu, you know, MMA, kickboxing. You know, when people come in the gym, they learn life lessons. It's not just about, oh, I'm gonna learn how to fight, or oh, I'm gonna learn how to be tough, or oh, self-defense. You know, all that stuff is great, but it's really about, you know, the overcoming adversity, the, you know, dedication, that being able to push when you don't want to push anymore, that martial arts brings to every aspect of life. Training schedule for fight camp. Well, we got a fight coming up March 30th. Coming up, so I'm in here 6 days a week. Sundays, come in 1 to 3, open mat sparring. Get some rolling in for an hour, sparring in for an hour, strength and conditioning afterwards. Mondays, come in, strength and conditioning for an hour at 5, teach kids class at 6, 7, Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu. Then Tuesdays, come in the gym and get here at 3 o'clock, do some yoga, a lot of stretching. 4 o'clock, yeah, another kid's jiu-jitsu class that we do. 5 o'clock, more strength and conditioning, one-on-one training with Coach Tim. 6 o'clock, boxing. 7 o'clock, MMA, full team practice. And then back on Wednesdays, come in for more strength and conditioning at 5. Back to kids' jiu-jitsu at 6. Adult jiu-jitsu at 7 to 8:30, sometimes 9, depending on, you know, how the day goes. Thursday is back in here at 3 o'clock, you know, back to the yoga, back to the stretching. Got to make sure to take care of myself. Kids jiu-jitsu at 4. That's the 4 o'clock class is my minis class. That's when we teach the 3 to 7 year olds. Definitely never too early to get them started. Then back one-on-one training and strength and conditioning at 5. Boxing with Coach James at 6. We got a lot of young guys in that program that I, you know, try to help build up. And back with the MMA team at 7. And then Fridays, using my lazy day, try to rest, recover, make sure that's my good diet day. Try to keep everything down. Saturday is more strength and conditioning, and then throw in a couple of extra sparring days to finish off the fight camp. But in here, all day, every day. You know, and being in the cage, you know, gets that adrenaline junkie out of me. Gets that need to go do something crazy, that need to go do something different, but in a positive way. I can be an inspiration to, you know, other people, you know, to my kids, you know, show them that, hey, you're never too old. Hey, you know, just because this happened in your past doesn't limit you to what you can achieve. It just, how bad do you want it? How bad do you want to go out there and get it? And like I said, I want it bad. So like I said, as far as I can reach, that's how far I'm going.